Hi guys, Yacca here, so I have a fun deck for you guys. If you like playing Priest, then this could be the one to go for you guys. It's a Menagerie Priest, it's what it's called. It kind of plays like exactly like a Control Priest. It's one of the good, very good lists out there. As you can see, we are actually at a quite good win rate so far at 70%. And I think the deck is just doing amazing stuff right now. So definitely a recommendation from my part here. About the deck, there's a little bit in here you have to be aware of. You have your Ansoth, and that's really why you call it a Menagerie Priest. Because you do have your Light Show Elementals, you have a Pirate, you have your Scorpits, and you will generate these out of Ansoth. You also have your Draconic Studies, which is amazing because you can generate some really high value dragons and get those back as well with Ansoth. And you just have a bunch of control tools, so all the aggressive decks out there, they don't stand a chance against you. You just have to be aware of how much they can actually push with regards to damage, and then you're in a quite a good spot. A almost certain guaranteed full heal would be to go for a Blademaster Samuro together with Apotheosis. That is an amazing play. Other than that, control the board, grind your opponent out of threats, and win the game. That's kind of the main idea behind it. The battle I have for you guys, the deck showcase, is actually how to manage a fatigue matchup with another priest. There, that's actually quite a different playstyle that you have to be really careful about how you actually manage that. So stay tuned for that. That is quite an amazing and fun run. And we will head on into that, and then you have quite a treat there. And I'd like to say thank you for watching, guys, and have fun with the gameplay that I have in store for you. And thanks for watching. Priest Mirror.
I foresaw this encounter. The shall bring victory.
This is less interesting. So is this. Making him overdraw could be great. If it's going to be a fatigue matchup, then I am a little bit unfavored because I'm one card down as opposed to my opponent. I'm not going to draw. It's going to be this. That allows me to pressure face in the beginning. Let's see if we can squeeze out something here. Lines up well, the Holy Smite. There we go. Then I'm probably not inclined to play my own Venom Scorpit.
When for me, when for you.
What am I? I get like apathy. Wave of apathy. Renew. So it's not going to do a lot in this matchup. Let's see. Draconic, Devouring Plague. I guess I'm going for the value route. Let's go for the Skeletal Dragon. Then I can go for Another Scorpid or... Let's just go for the Blade Master now. And then heal him. Sure. Death, because we have light shower elementals and stuff. We really would like some heart removal. Then I can drop the skeletal dragon. That gets him to scoop it and a scoundrel. Is he trying to fatigue me? I think he's going for the fatigue route. Nine, that's only eight. He needs a little bit more. I'm gonna be at nine cards. I wonder. Could also palm reading. Really a lot of options here. Let's go for the school pit, palm reading. Guess renew. Draconic. Let me get rid of that one. Maybe I get some kind of spell burst and can wait with that one. But I also have a couple of scoundrels still. This is definitely a value matchup. Let's see, I am able to pressure face a little bit. Generating some threats. But it's just... It's just one Blade Master away. I can just Hysteria that one. Let's just hit face. We can also wait with hitting. If he hits there, then I can apotheosis, but then again, it's not too great. Not what I want to... drop the scoundrel. Do this. Not that one, because I have Ensoth in my hand. Soul Mirror, Venomous Scorpid. I think the Scorpid. And I could go for the skeletal dragon and apotheosis on the spider. The spider has scorpion. What do you have? Palm reading. A bunch of generated stuff. Oh well. Getting a little bit of my own medicine here. Hey, overdraw. Let's go for it. I want to get the card first. Apotheosis, I guess that's fine. Let's see what kind of dragon we're getting here. Just that one. Just gonna do this.
My hand is full.
That's nice. Not getting any more scoundrels. The fatigue plan is coming together. Is one more scoundrel? And then I have two race debts as well, where I might generate scoundrels. That's fine. Here I can just go ahead four and generate two. I'll be fine. Let's just push a bunch of stuff here. There we go. So, what do I need? A light shower elemental? Haven't generated that one yet. But I do get the amalgam, circus amalgam. But is that it? And a venomous scorpion. Might want to go for the skeletal dragon this turn. And then he has. Okay, hysteria. Yeah, that clears. Isn't that it with hysteria? I think that is the case. This means that I can go and he's generated something, which is definitely possible. And I'll do this. Can site split this to generate even more threats. I would like to go for an apotheosis. Oh, no more scoundrels. Oh, man. He's definitely going for that fatigue plane. So maybe I pressure him. But again, it's just one Blade Master Samuro away from him being completely healed.
What must I do?
Okay. Death is a little bit awkward. Could just hit into that one twice. If I don't. There we go. Fine. not going to put anything else on that one. He has a death in his hand, I know that. And then what, a death and... I think this is the most I can get out of it. And if I get the skeletal dragon, then there's still room. I don't. And I don't want to generate anything else because then I'll overdraw. That only gets him so far. He's not gonna clear everything. Holy smite and then clear. Okay. Go for psych splits. We can't clear just yet. What does he have? He has nothing. Okay, what do we do then? Go for psych splits. An apotheosis. Generates me a couple of cards. Let's go over the cards first. Okay. Guess I'll just do this just to get rid of it. I can psych split. Be careful with that. I just had to concentrate a little bit. I am in a bit of an awkward spot here because I am still a little bit further away in fatigue and he still has his in Soth. But then I also have my soul mirror. Right now the pressure is a little bit on his side. My blade. He's got the apotheosis. Is that it? But he needs more to clear. That only clears one minion, unless he also trades the other one. That clears most of it. Okay. And then I can just stare in. I'm definitely gonna wait with that one until he drops his own. Let's see if we can get the scoundrel, maybe. And Seth would be nice. To get a scoundrel. I think I want a hysteria first. And we're just gonna do like so. This is actually okay, because that's a way for me to play around his Mutanus. Oh, not his Mutanus, his and Soth. Just have one. Nine cards. It doesn't have in Seth yet. He would have played it if he had it. This is fine. Then I need to just find a way to clear that. See if we can get a death. Plus three. We are getting there with this one. It's 8, 10, 13, and then the condemn. Let's do that. Apotheosis. Let's do that. There we go. We condemn you! And then I renew that one, just to generate another card. Auspicious spirits. That's fine. Now, right now, I'm probably not going to hit and Soth with Mutanus. So just might as well play it, because if he draws into Ensoth, if he plays it, he'll play it right away. But then I do have the Soul Mirror to take care of that one. He hesitated a little bit, so it could be that he drew it and just wanted to make sure that he didn't take 10 points of damage. And if not... Okay. I guess it wasn't that one. Still have erased it, maybe to well, that gives me a target for Mutanus. Hopefully it's a big one. Let's generate a drain first. Skeletal? Maybe a Sarah is better. I think Sarah is better. I'm gonna do this. And I will heal you. Haha. I'm not sure which kind of spot I'm in here. He's playing some other cards than I am, but... He might still be running in Soth, either way.
What must I do?
Then I can Auspicious Spirits and Light Shower Elemental on the next turn. Maybe do a trade. I need to take some care of the board control, I guess. I guess I can do that first. Magic is not a toy. Do not lose me. All right. matter too much, I think. Could generate some stuff here. I'll go for the other Whale Weaver and just do this first. I think that's the case. That's nice. And then we will... Will we drop this one? Sure. He's not getting anything out of that lifesteal. What have you got? Shadow Form. It's not healing anymore, but I guess he doesn't exactly need that. Well, condemn now would be just fine. Okay, he's taking care of it, but a condemn is still fine for me. Do I palm reading? I guess it can wait. If I do this... I don't really want to dream that one. Let's just drop this or not. Yeah, sure. Let's drop this. Trades with that one, and I still have Soul Mirror for his Ensoth. Mind Render Illusion is kind of a dead draw. He instigates the train. Alright. Here we're gonna use the Soul Mirror. Then I can palm reading to generate that one. Guess Hysteria clears the board eventually. Guess that's better. And then we get what? Okay. All good and fine. I do have some good ways of generating some stuff here.
What do the cards say?
4 and 3. Still have a race debt, which would allow me to generate another. He is just clearing. I don't really feel that he has the opportunity to out-control me here, but... I'm thinking the probability for him to clear his own minions are quite good. I could also Divine Shield my own stuff here. To increase the chance. And then I do have the renews for this ethics. I think this is fine. I'm gonna hysteria on that one. Perfect. And then if I psych splits, maybe I want to wait with that one. Sure. And then got double Sethic and psych splits, maybe. Does that make sense? I could also raise that for another and Soth. I do have the option to do that. I get a really high impact minion. He's kind of out of resources as well. Ooh. Do I psych split that one? Could also just push it back. Sure. Let's see if he trades. Well, else I'll dream it on the next turn. It costs one, right? Nightmare. Actually need to do this because I wanted to get the race dead. It's really important. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And I still have room for race dead. I think I do have a hole at the better end of the stick here. He needs to still have some high impact minions, and I do have a lot already, I do know that. And he's kind of iron control tools. He still has a dragon though. And if he gets an Isera, that will be quite bad. Okay. Could be an Isera turn. It seems like a Hail Mary. Right now I'm kind of in the mindset of Isera Awakens. Hysteria? What does he want to do? Death? Shoot that one. Okay. That will be a story. Okay. This guy Sarah awakens and then heal, I guess. Maybe drop a minion. Guess I'll heal the minion. I'm just gonna drop the amount rate. That's pressure. He needs to be able to clear this. Or else I'll... Another one! That's four raised debts. Now you can get your scoundrels. That's fine. There's no more cards to draw. Do we have it? Magic is not. Stop generating stuff, would you? Do not lose this. Huh?
What knowledge do the stars provide?
Ouch. Let's generate some cards. Renew. Feast. Then I guess I want to generate another one of these. Let's make it a little bit more open for him. Okay, get any more cards, so this is fine.
I am out of cards.
Another soul mirror. So what are you gonna do? Death. But I could still, he can clear 1, 2. And I can still psych split. Flesh Heal is a targeted one, yeah. So I might want to go for initiation and holding over. He's going face. Why? I don't think that's right. There we go. Okay, I can do that one. Really want to dream that one. Let's go for this. I'm the one that can generate cards. He cannot. Still needed to do a little bit more there. So next time I can death. I still have my hero power left. He's gonna shoot that one. Okay. Let's death this one first. One, two, three, four, five, and I have three left. Let's see which kind of dragon we're getting here. Guess I want to go for runaway Blackwing. Then I'll just go for a Laughing Sister. and a bit of healing. He has a dragon, and he has two dragons. Okay. Another one. Okay, that's kind of... that's fine. Yeesh. Could have been awkward if he got the runaway Blackwing. Okay. What do we really want to go for here? Could get the this one might get that one, and then I hit that one. There's two good options there. I could also go for that one and that one, and that's 9, and the fatigue damage. Getting a little bit concerned about the fatigue. Let's raise that, see what we get. Want him to generate anything, and then we're gonna do this. One of these two guys. That's fine. And I might have only 9, but then I do have Flesh Heal and Light Shell Elemental still. And he's incentivized to try and clear the 9-9, because that's pretty much gonna do him in just a few turns. There we go. Can't target that one. I could just dream that one, hit his face. A heal for a lot, and just go face. Because then he is gonna take another 3 and 5, that's 8, and then that's lethal. Could still play. What was that? Enixia again. That's gonna be a little bit awkward for me, but not too much, I think. I should be able to survive. Whereas he will not. So then I could just hit initiation, and then he's on 4, 5, and 6, that's 11, and he's not healing. And then he's just gonna Anixia, and then I'll remove 2 dragons. That one. That's not enough, right? I'm game. Move a bit of damage over there. Just gonna heal myself. And then that's gonna be 5. Does he have a healing spell? He has a dragon. He has... what is that generated by? Also minions. He only has that one left. That could be a spell. The rest is minions. Just gonna shoot me for what? Six, seven. Woohoo! We won the fatigue game! Oh, there's quite a bit of strategy to go into that. Thanks for watching, guys.